that 99% of American adult women will use birth control at some point. The bottom line is this. No woman seeking to make the right decision for herself and her family about whether or when to become pregnant should ever have to choose.
There's right and there's wrong, and sometimes what's right and what's wrong, the middle line gets a little bit muddy. It gets a little bit unclear what's right and what's wrong. But one thing you can say about Trump is you can take his own words that he said, that you have recorded, that you see, not hearsay, not the old stuff that gets just thrown back into politics and all that stuff about whether or not he's a true politician, but the stuff about that he says directly out his own mouth. Mm-hmm. I hate women. This is, I can objectify women. I can use African Americans. This is what I think of people whose lifestyle doesn't fit with my image, my narrative. So that's what I'm saying for people. Where is your bottom line? When you support Trump, what are you supporting from him? Because my whole thing is support somebody, I have to agree wholeheartedly with their mission. And do you agree with the things he's saying? Because when I see people who voted for Trump, I think to myself, let me keep my kids away because my kids are African American. Or let me keep my family members away because some of them are gay. Or let me keep the women away, period, because he doesn't value women. He thinks that he can just objectify women, and that's not what I believe in. That's not my personal belief. So for Trump supporters, you gotta ask yourself, what's your bottom line? What's your right and wrong? Like, because that line for Trump, that's clearly down the middle for me. Like, I could clearly see. I could see the side we're right at, and I could see the line where wrong is. And I am definitely on the side of right, and he is definitely on the side of wrong. So it's no muddy for that line at all.
And your name is?
I'll take that, F.
His changes affect you?
It's gonna mess me up because I pay my rent and stuff. That's how I get through the month. And I can't say that. And then you're taking the health care away from the older people and the ones who really need it. And then you saying all this extra stuff. But what are you going to do with the ones who don't have health care? What are you trying to do for them?
I am here because I want to take a stand for and support women's rights and as well as refugees, immigrants, a free press. For treating different people with respect, and I'm glad to be able to make it here today. I see a really positive vibe.
Well, I didn't want to miss this historic opportunity to lend my voice and my presence to a movement that I think is so positive and so wonderful. This is the first time in my life when I've felt a true solidarity with just so many women, women from all spectrums of the rainbow, women who are old and young and babies and mothers who are here with their children and grandmothers who are here and men and fathers and brothers. This is such a positive day. I've not heard any mention or any negative references to women. Women being called biatches, women being called hoes, women being called anything negative, and it's absolutely wonderful. Even the horrible term that our newly elected person in Washington tried to use and denigrate women in a horrible way has been used in a positive way today. I'm so happy to see all the pink hats. Little pussy cats that women are wearing. It's beautiful representation of how something so negative can be so positive. And today, we're going to roar. We're not going to be little pussy cats. We're going to be lionesses, and we're going to roar. And I think the message that's being conveyed here today is going to reach out to all neighborhoods in Philadelphia and across the country. And women are finally, because of something negative that happened on November the 9th, women are finally.
Check 1, 2, 1, 2. I'm here today at the Women's March. It's January 21st, 2017. We're taking a stand. We're letting our new president-elect know that we will not go back. We are not going back. We've come too far, and we're not going back. I'm out here because I'm fighting for women. Women as a woman, not as the property of a man, but women as equals in our country. And that's all I'm going to say. I'm happy that this march happened. And sometimes we got to see all the ugly stuff in our society before we start doing the right thing. So I have to thank the new president-elect for all of this. All of this right here, all of us coming together, is because of you. And I have to thank you for that much. Now, we just have to stay together and make sure our rights is protected. We have to stay together and make sure that we get ahead. And yeah, I know there's nasty women out there and they have this slogan. I'm not trying to be a nasty woman. I don't want to do it the nasty way. I want to be able to talk to you, you talk to me, and we make things happen the way they're supposed to happen. So again, this is January 21st, 2017. We're at the Women's March here in Philadelphia. We're marching all over the world today to let people know that we are not your property. We are human beings, and we have a right to be treated like human beings equally, the same way you are treated as a man. Peace. Busy in the house. Busy in the house. You know how we do. One.
Come on. On the arena.
Yeah.
concern, different issues and concerns. I'm finding so many different mentality. It seems challenging. I don't say hard because the only thing hard is being concrete that you walk on. Everything else is a challenge. So I'm ready for this challenge, and I was built for this. I think that we all have a purpose in life, and mine.